Hello, everyone. This is episode number 3 of the Crisis Diaries, and the actual, like, vlogging and me talking to the camera aspect of this video is going to be less polished. I've been using, like, nice tripod and light setups in the past few videos, and the reason for that is the focus of this week is rule number 9 of the 10 Commandments of Crisis, and rule number 9 is rest and replenish. Now, admittedly, I didn't do necessarily the best job of that this week. Yesterday, I went for a run, a super hard run that was really, really difficult, probably the hardest run I've ever done. And I found out that on my training plan, it was actually supposed to be a rest day, so I screwed that up. I did work quite a bit this week, but the plan was just to kind of take in some more media, whether that were movies, podcasts, just some time to actually like relax and recharge because I have been going pretty hard. And ultimately I ended up working more than I had planned and I didn't take in quite as much. But I did have a great week and I did some things that definitely helped me to replenish, that kind of filled my cup. I did a bunch of painting this week and kind of just making fun little art projects. So at the start of the week, I thought about what I wanted to make and I made this little pinup of different art ideas. So today I'm just gonna go through these each and kind of show you what I got up to this week. So the first one says ball cap. And all that is this ball cap that I have on right here. My friend Colin gave me this hat the other day when I shaved my head. I said I needed some hats. He said he had a whole bunch that he never wears. Since I was painting, I was really liking the way that like paint strokes were looking on the paper and I wanted to make this hat a little bit more mine. So I put a white paint stroke across the front and where it says the antisocial social club, I just put some black paint on there. I thought that looked cool. The next thing was, it just says bowls right there. So like so many others, I've been loving the Chicago Bulls documentary series on Netflix. So, so cool. And one of the people that resonated with me most in that whole series or that I really enjoyed was Dennis Rodman. And I don't know if it was on the series or in an article that I had read, but someone had referred to Rodman as being a colorful character. And I don't even know what they meant by that. They could have meant that in a negative sense and having not understood him, but I like that. I like colorful people. I like people who are eclectic and fun to watch or be around. I just wanted to make a fun little painting for him and to celebrate his colorfulness, we will say. I knew that Mother's Day was coming up, so I have mom written right there. I don't even know how this came to mind, but I knew that I was doing some painting and some collaging and making a scrapbook, so I thought I would make one of the pieces for mom. I asked my dad to send me some old photos of her and I, and he sent me some really nice ones. And when I saw them, I was thinking back to her and I and our relationship when I was younger, and I thought of the old Club Monaco, like vintage sweaters that people wore in the 90s. And I thought about the M in Club Monaco, M-O. I knew that that could spell mom if I were to cut that out. I remember my mom singing You Are My Sunshine when I was a kid, and I looked that up and found the old Johnny Cash version, thought that would be fun. So yeah, I'll just play that now.
1, 2, 3. My sunshine, my only sunshine. You make me happy when skies are gray. You'll never know, dear, how much I love you. Please don't take my sunshine away.
And then the second last thing on this list was just, it's a journal. I have been writing in a journal for several months now, every morning, and really, really falling in love with that process. And my friend showed me this really cool guy, like a runner slash painter on Instagram. His handle is Mango Peeler, and he's here in Toronto. And he was painting on the front of all his running journals, and I thought that that was really awesome, so I stole that. Thank you for the inspiration. And I painted over top of my journal. I had some old cutouts from some of the collages that I've been doing, some that didn't make it into a collage. I tried like a purple and sort of tealy color. It sort of ended up looking like a nebula or like a galaxy with the black background. So I cut the moon in half, made like a double moon that I thought looked cool. Popped the astronaut in there. Then I ended up taking some silver paint and sort of splattering it over to try to get like a starry look. And yeah, I thought it was really cool. Now it's just fun to open up the journal in the morning and have that bit of a fun cover to it. Makes it just that much more nice. And then the very last thing, it just says green screen. So with the painting that I was doing, again, I was really loving the look of the brush strokes, and I thought that that could look cool as like an intro title. So I went over here, threw down some green paper, shined a light, shone. I don't know what the past tense word for shine is, but yeah, just did a little brush stroke, wrote the Crisis Diaries over top of it, digitally masked out that green, and that was the intro to this video. But yeah, I think that's it for this week. Checked off all of these boxes. I'm gonna actually check them off right now because that feels really good, and I haven't like literally checked any of these off, so I'm gonna enjoy that right now. All right, that's it. That's the whole list. It was nice to get a tiny bit more rest this week. It was nice to just have some fun, spend some time doing some arts and crafts type stuff. It's really fun to just sort of dive into different mediums, different parts of the creative process, and to toil and meddle around and try to figure out how these things can influence my style and just make my brain feel good, because there's a global pandemic and it's really easy to not have your brain feel good. Anyway, thank you for watching, guys. If you want to keep watching along, feel free to give this video a like and to subscribe. And hope you're doing well. Hope you're staying sane. Hope you're finding some creative output or energy yourself, if that's what you're looking for. And see you next week. Thanks.